was on the 4th of May, half past 8 o'clock that day, J.B. Markham was standing in the door of a courthouse in his town where Kurt Jett was lurking round just to get a chance to lay him on the floor. Thomas White, a friend of Jett, no worse man was ever met, then came walking boldly through the courthouse hall. And as he was passing by, he looked Markham in the eye, knowing truly well poor Markham soon would fall. White walked out upon the street, stopped to see it all complete. He expected soon to hear the fatal shot. Jett advanced across the hall with his pistol let him fall, and he killed poor J.B. Markham on the spot. Poor Markham, J.B. Markham, poor Markham is dead. J.B., don't be maybe, poor Markham is dead. Judge Jim Hawkins and his man, Sheriff Edward Callahan, were across the street in Hawkins Brothers' store. Some believed they knew the plot and were listening for the shot, and to see Jett's victim fall there in the door. Captain Hewitt standing by, saw him fall and heard him cry, "Oh Lord, oh Lord, they've killed me now at last." And when he saw the men had guns, then he hastily did run, when he heard a second loud and awful blast. They arrested White and Jett, and the courts in Jackson met, where the prosecution labored with its might. And when Breathitt's court was o'er, Judge Red Wine could do no more, so he left it to the jury for the right. The jury disagreed. Just one man began to plead that he thought Kurt Jett and White should both go free. He contended to the last that his vote he would not cast. Some believe Judge Hawkins paid the man a fee.
Now they tried again once more, not in Jackson as before, for they could not get their justice in that town. So the courts in Harrison met and condemned both White and Jett, and a verdict of their guiltiness was found.
Now their mothers grieve today, oh, their boys while they're away, for there's nothing that can sever mother's love. She will pray for them each breath, cling to them until death, and will hope to meet them in the courts above.
Poor Marcum, J.B. Marcum, poor Marcum is dead.